is we've got two short loops, each of about 2 kilometers, plus the main track comes up to 3.76 kilometers. So we've got three configurations we can run, which is good. So it keeps us, you know, all the time short loops. A short loop is great for training.
Don't shuffle your hands. Okay, be very, very conscious of it when you're doing. Only then the car will be completely in your control. A race track driving is completely different from a road car driving.
We are here at the beautiful MMRT, which is today playing host to the students of the HIET. It's my pleasure as the Vice President of the Madras Motorsports Club and a partner at Wallace Sport to welcome the students to what is going to be a very, very unique day. We've never had this before. We've gathered a batch of 16 students from the college who all are here to hone their engineering skills, to learn about driving techniques, to have a track experience like they never have before. I've got my team here of instructors and safety people who are going to take the students through what's going to be an interesting 3 sessions. Now, I'm going to show you some of the little saloon cars and the differences of racing and rallying, which is something as a learning curve for everybody to. As we say, the racetrack is our laboratory. All over the world, vehicle manufacturers, college students, engineering graduates all use the motorsport arenas as the laboratory to test products. It's the only way where you can, in a matter of very short moments of time, you can check the stress levels, you can check components which normally would take you years of testing on a normal road. This is what we provide here at the Madras Motor Racetrack. The students are going to go through their basic program today from HIET along with my instructors. Thereafter, the plan is to have the HIET Championship or the HIET Cup, which will be solely for HIET students driving these beautiful Toyota Etios cars. These have been prepared with all racing components imported in from TRD Development, which is Toyota Racing Development. They have raced once before, they've been all redone, and we are now going to launch what is called the HIET racing program for their students alone. It's a unique one. It's never happened in India before. But there's always a start, and there's always to go down in the annals of history as the first to do it. This is a proper racing car. It's got slick tires made by MRF, which is what we use for tarmac, so that we get as much rubber between the car and the tarmac as possible for better grip. It's made with a soft compound for better handling. I'll show you the difference between a race and a rally tire now. This is what we call a rally tire. This is made by JK, which is again a component which the tire are made exclusively only for off-road. So this is an off-road rally tire. And this is the difference between racing and rallying. We are going to get going only with racing for now. Rallying will come later.
Hi guys, I'm Alisha Abdullah, car and bike racer, won a lot of laurels and championships to my name, and I'm from India. So today I'm at the MMRT racetrack, and we're just training the students after the students had gone through a very brief, detailed infrastructure about the track and how to race and how to learn, especially before you race. And then so I'm here now with Hindustan students to teach them what a function of a car is basically. So we have different functions in a race car. This is a polo car, but it has a lot of functions, it's just not your regular car on the road. So this is what I'm going to speak today with one of the students. And so yeah, so let's get started. So here I am at the MRT racetrack. So today Alisha Racing is associated with HITS Chennai. So today we are associated with Hindustan for many years, and our work is to make the students on the track and off the track to learn more about the race cars and race bikes. And I think all the students over here are very excited to get on the track, and let's see what they have inside them.
I have driven a Polo before.
Okay.
But this car is a pretty different, obviously, because it's a race car and has more specifications.
Yes. So right now we just finished the session inside, the briefing session inside.
Yes.
And so now today, after the briefing session, you would have learned about the infrastructure of the track, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, so today now we just came out of the pit lane, and I'm going to show you how we actually drive on a race track. And what is the different components in this car than a road car?
Yes, ma'am. Okay, yes, ma'am. I've driven a Polo before.
Okay.
On the road.
Okay.
But it's the first time I'm on a specification of a race car on the racetrack. So what is the difference, ma'am, between a normal road traffic and a race car?
So in this race car, we have a roll gauge.
Yes.
We have a roll gauge, which is like, you know, you don't have to, when you drive fast, you will not fall, you know, your thing will not, it will not topple. If it topples, this will avoid it for it to crash. So this is a roll gauge.
Okay, ma'am.
And then we have, there's no AC, the AC is the air condition, but we don't use it because we need, the faster it goes, we don't need air condition in the car. So when you drive the race car, we actually put up the glass so much. So this is how the glass is when you drive a race car. Basically for aerodynamics, we use this. But right now, it will get hot in here. So I'm just going to roll down the glass down.
Yes.
So this is the ignition switch. In a normal car, you will not see this.
Yes.
So right now it's on, so this side. But once you park the car, you can off it. So this is how it is, and if you see the steering wheel, it's like not the normal ones.
Yes.
You have, it's like, it's completely different, you know. It's not like the normal ones.
In a normal road, we always prefer to drive in the middle, but on a racetrack, we
have the
okay.
Effect. That's because we have racing lines we have all over.
Yes.
So we have on the left, we have on the right, we have. So basically, this is how we drive on a racetrack. So if you're going to go in between, like what we're doing now, is for people to know about the track.
Yes.
But we're going to go extreme right and then left.
Yes.
That's for basically outer line and inner line.
Yes.
So that one you will learn as the time passes by, you will learn all that in a race.
Okay.
So we take a defensive line, which means we go innermost corner of the track.
Okay.
So that time we defend our position, we say. You know,
yes.
We defend our line, so that's why we go to the innermost, so that the other guy will not take us. So there are so many things to racing, it's just not driving a car.
Ma'am, how do you actually, the concept of braking points, I usually get it when the theoretical classes are going on, but sometimes when I come on the track, I flash out, and maybe because I'm not up to the speed, or maybe I'm too low for the speed. So how is the braking point actually work on the racetrack?
Yeah, so see, now since I'm going at slow speed, you can actually, this is how we teach people. So when we go on a slow speed, we go slow, and on the apex we don't brake. We always brake at a braking point. So we brake there and then we turn. You know, after I show you the track, I'm going to take you for a round, and I'm going to show you what is a braking point.
Okay.
So we basically see, so for example, if that is the tree, that's our braking point. So we come here, we go fast, and then for example, we see the tree at a side of our eye, and we just brake, and then we turn the car, and we go flat out. We don't brake in the corners. If you brake in the corners, you have high chances of toppling the car, and also you have high chances of sliding out, and there will be an accident for you and for others.
Okay.
So it is very necessary to know the basics before you enter on the racetrack.
Okay.
So talk of the suit.
What is the suit actually for racing? I mean, how safe? Well, coming to the safety measures, we know we have to wear a helmet and some safety gear.
So basically, the suit is FIA approved, and this is a three-layered racing suit. So if you can see, it has like so if the car catches on fire, it takes about 5 seconds to get in my skin. So there is a reaction time for your skin, basically for your brains, you know, to react and jump out of the car.
The reflex.
Yeah, so that is the reason. But yes, it is really hot. We race under 68 degrees inside the race car whenever you race. It's very hot, so that's why fitness is really important.
Okay, and what are the fitnesses that you concentrate for your racing?
We mainly concentrate on breathing techniques, because see, when you're on the suit, it's like a thermowear, and you can't breathe because of the heat and the helmet and stuff. So because the heat generates from here, especially in this climate, we don't pull our glasses down, we don't have AC. So our there's no form of air inside the car. But again, it's all cardio and it's all about your breathing techniques. So there's fitness plays a very big role in terms of racing.
Okay. So what are the risk factors of a fracture or a major accident when you compare a car and a bike?
Yeah, so the that's a very scary question. So for a bike, when we ride, the risk factors are you injure your collarbone. Like I had a concussion in my head when I was in bike racing. I had a fall on my head, and it was on a super bike. So there are many mishaps happening. You get fractures basically, and your body gets hit very badly because people fall all over, you know. Because here at least we are on four wheels, but when it comes to two wheelers, it's not easy, you know. In two wheelers, it's like everywhere, all over the place we are. So that's the problem in bike racing. In car racing, mostly what happens is we just get caught and it just burns, maximum only that. Even if it topples also, nothing will happen to you. If you topple the car, you just topple, but you are very safe, because thanks to the roll gauge, we are very, very, the FIA approved roll gauge. So nothing will happen to you. Cars are very safe, but very, very challenging to race, especially even on the full racing gear.
Especially when you sit and you're strapped on and you have all the
Yes.
Okay.
And the difference is, in our bike racing suit, we wear about 10 kilos suit on us. And if it's a car racing, it's hardly about 2 or 3 kilos. So, you know, you're carrying extra weight on your body, which is very hard, you know.
I'm really honored and it's a privilege, ma'am, to be riding next to you. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Swati. It means a lot. And I want you to, think about racing, because I want more women to come into racing.
Yes, ma'am. Yes. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you for your words of encouragement.
Thank you, Swati.
Hi, my name is David Ryan and I'm a third year student from Hindustan, and I'm here at MMRT. This is a Caterham, it's from the 90s. I'm a racer from Hindustan, racing 3 seasons. I've won all 3 seasons, and Hindustan has helped me reach heights of success that I've never known before. I'm a third year, I'm about to finish in 1 year, and also come back for my higher studies, but also Hindustan supports my racing career. So I'm extremely grateful that they are helping me. So this is one of the cars that Hindustan has given me to race in. I've raced 3 seasons, and this is an LG Balakrishnan. This car has been restored by Hindustan. It sits in one of their garages, but comes out during races. I've been able to win every single race that I've participated in because of the car and because of the maintenance that they've done on the car.